means when someone is involved in that particular activity, how involved are they? So engaged typically speaks to a certain high level of involvement, right? Do you guys know who this guy is?
Yes.
That's Benny McCarthy, right?
Yeah.
What position does he play?
Right?
What do you think would happen if he was a
goalkeeper?
Who's this guy? What happened when, what position does he play? What happened when he was a striker? Do you know he was a striker at some point? What happened?
He was told he's useless.
He's useless, right? When he changed and played the right position, he became very successful very quickly.
The actual child is a striker at first and chiefs.
That example sums up what I'm going to talk to you about today. Is how do you know you're playing the right position? How do you know in your job that you're playing the right position? How do you know what your talent is and therefore being in the right position? Don't you think it's an important question to have asked ourselves when we're sitting in the chair? Or even stand at 8? Me, I didn't do grades. I did standards. I know I look like a millennial, but but honestly, folks, we at some point early enough in our lives, we need to start understanding what our talents and gifts are. And so this tool that I'm going to be touching on today is a tool that we use through the companies like Contribution Compass, Comensa, and so forth, right? So we've, people like myself and Uprasam, we've been certified and accredited to be able to facilitate and to provide this tool and to help professionals, the youth, business people, and unemployed people to better understand what we like to term as natural talent. We call it natural energy, aka or also known as natural talent. Don't you think it would be important for all of us to know really what our talents are? It would, right? So I'm going to share some concepts with you. Please keep reminding me if we go to...
Okay.
There's about 15 minutes left or whatever the case may be. Cool. So the question I want to ask you is, what do you do with your time? What do you spend your time mostly doing? Question.
I do a lot.
You do a lot, right?
I go to soccer games. Because I'm no longer playing, but I'm still involved, so I do go to fields on weekends and watch soccer games. I go to the mall with my friend.
Tell me about during the week about your job, because that's where you spend most of your time, right?
So I do a lot. I do a lot.
Working
I'm
for someone else, I'm sure you do a lot.
Yes, yes. Yeah.
Ma, what do you do? What do you do for a living?
I'm an educator.
You're an educator? Right. So during the week, are you teaching? And who do you teach, kids?
No,
or
adults?
College. Like, what are your favorite subjects?
I used to teach.
And then what are you? What are some of the people? What are some of the subjects you're teaching now?
Midwifery.
Yeah. Oh. What subjects have you taught that you didn't enjoy?
Community.
Okay.
Community is about dealing with the well and unwell people in the community away from the hospital.
How did it make you feel when you were learning and needing to talk to other people about this subject?
I didn't have that confidence, you know.
What happens to your level of performance and energy when you don't have the confidence or you feel that? Sorry, I sound like I'm interjecting. I do that. I think it's one of my talents. So let's compare how you felt about that particular subject versus someone you truly loved that same subject, where, how, if you were to compare the level of performance, who do you think would typically perform better? Someone who enjoys it or someone who doesn't?
I think it will depend on the expectations from your employer and also the target that has been set.
Let's say everything is the same. Let's say everything is the same except for someone likes the subject, the other person doesn't like the subject. The level of performance, who do you think would perform better?
there were lots of issues in there, because the main thing is how do you teach, how do you perceive your clients, you know, the very candidates, and that also plays a very much important role, because it's not production of material, it's production of people.
Yes.
Yeah.
But in general, if we had to say in soccer, right, if we had to have to have players who love soccer and some who don't love soccer. Sorry, which week? Yes.
You know what, I think we can ask those people to keep their voices down.